We're about 2 weeks into incubation, and there is one egg that has a fair amount of mold that just developed, and another egg that has the beginnings of mold right here. But both of them are still showing very healthy veins throughout. I'll show you here. Or we'll show you. See, they're very red, very good veins on both of them, so there's really no point in throwing them out, because they could still hatch. I mean, there's still a really good chance of them hatching. So we are going to separate this one with mold into its own container to prevent that from spreading to the other eggs. And we are going to put on some lotrimin powder. Now this is for antifungal remedies in humans, but it works really well for funguses and eggs too. Let's take off this mold that's developed on it. Kind of rub it onto the egg, and this should prevent more from growing, but we are still going to separate it just in case. And just to be safe, we will put this other one in there too that had the start of some mold right here, and we'll treat it too. These will be separated from everyone else. Now our bottom tray is the one with perlite. And on the plus side, all of these eggs look great. So I'm starting to really like perlite because we haven't had any problems with any of these eggs. And where was, I still don't know which one the sluggy one was, but apparently it wasn't sluggy. Here's egg number 25, looking great. Yeah, look at that. That was a nice surprise egg too. We are gonna add a little bit of water to these eggs. And when you're adding water, make sure you don't dump it right on the egg, of course. Add it to the corners of the tray or in between the eggs. Now, a nice thing about perlite is that you can actually have a small layer of water at the bottom, and that won't even touch the eggs, whereas vermiculite seems to absorb it and spread the moisture throughout. It doesn't just sit on the bottom. So I'm starting to like perlite so far. We'll set their lid back on and throw them back in for a couple more weeks. If you have a window develop in the shell of your egg, where it's just a see-through hole and you can see right through the shell, you want to apply a combination of lotrimin powder and school glue, the non-toxic kind, of course, and this will prevent the hole from spreading, it'll prevent fungus from growing, and the glue will help strengthen the shell of the egg. It is the day after we checked in on our bull snake eggs, and it's perfect timing that we got a clutch of hognose snake eggs with a hole, or a window in one of them. And it's really neat. You can see the veins through the window here, so it is a fertile egg. But we are going to patch it up with the glue and the lotrimin powder I was just mentioning. It's about 2 weeks after I applied the Elmer's glue and lotrimin powder to the window on this little hognose snake egg, and you can't even tell that it used to have a window. It looks perfect now, and it's developing quite nicely, so hopefully if you ever have a window in one of your eggs, you should be able to patch it up just like we did here. There also haven't been any recurring mold issues with these bull snake eggs, so the lotrimin trick seemed to have worked perfectly. And while we're looking at bull snake eggs, We'll give you an update on these egg-eating snake eggs as well, because I know a few of you are interested in these. I'll hit the light. They are also developing very well so far. I'm super excited about these eggs. And we see veins in all of them. There was one egg that was separated from the rest that was kind of collapsed to begin with, and that one did not make it, but these other six look great.